Hello, welcome to Dungeon Scavenger. This is a little indie game that actually has a lot of potential. I mean, it's basically a dungeon crawling roguelike RPG, and it has a lot of systems that will remind you of the good old games. And to be honest, I like the old good old games. Now, before I do that, I just want to show you some of the things you can do, because if I just show you the combat, you won't like it. This is not a game that has pretty combat. In the beginning, you can choose your class: knight, paladin, warrior. You are the knight, barbarian, thief, mage, sorcerer, hunter, and necromancer. I'll actually show you more of the necromancer, because each of them has special abilities. For example, the paladin. You can have regeneration, heavy armor, heavy hammers, hammer time. And each of them plays very, very different. As you can see, the thief will only wear medium armor, and he's more like poison, lifesteal, drain, these kinds of things. And then you have, of course, the hunter, which has charm animal, meaning you can have an animal companion, like a big kitty. And of course, the bows and all those things. And then there is the necromancer, which has charm undead, decay. Yeah, all that nice stuff. Now let's go back and let's actually do my game with the necromancer. And as you can see, they have random names. Yeah, I did a tutorial, and this is how the dungeon looks like. So if you don't... First of all, let me show you the other things you can do in the game. The music is quite pleasant, and as you can see, the menu is quite... You know, it's a minimalistic approach. This is your pet ghost that actually... I caught him in the dungeon, so you're basically like a ghostbuster, and he becomes your friend after that. Now, before you go into a dungeon, you need to buy a lot of supplies, and you actually see what each item does. All guilds, meaning you, by the way, you are a hero in a guild, and this is your level. That means the level of the guild is basically your level, to put it shortly. And these are kind of all your stats, so you can really spec up into different builds, very, very different builds. And they're pretty simple, but believe me, you can make some very diverse builds here, and these are all your stats: resistances, and of course damage and elemental attack. Of course, we are a necromancer, and we work better with shadow spells. So yeah, you can buy health potions, supplies like minion food, rations, beer, more beer, for stamina regeneration and health regeneration in the dungeon, to better protect yourself against the elements, to reveal, because the map in the dungeon has a fog of war. To escape, use a smoke bomb. Some scrolls, because even if you play the warrior, you can still charm an animal to join your side, or an undead, because hey, that's funny, being a warrior with a skeleton on your side. And chess keys, of course. Up to 3, so sometimes you'll find items in the dungeon, so don't buy all of them to maximum. Well, maybe the rations and the beer and the minion food. And then you can also buy a lot of items, and believe me, they go further than this. These are just the basic items you can buy. Now here you have the zoo, where, I mean, you can you can put your pet here to rest, the inn where you get all your quests, because you also have a lot of quests, the alleyway. Okay, let's buy an item from the mysterious stranger in the alley. Hey, what do you have for me? Random equipment. Shadow Novice armor. Well, that's a nice piece. And this is your equipment screen. So, I have a plain shadow armor. 4-4-1. So yeah, this actually has more shadow resistance. So let's wear this. Besides, if you make a set, you'll have immunity to shadow and decay. And that means you can basically make a fire set, an acid set, and so on. But that is a little later in the game. You can also see the seeker to enhance your equipment, or to locate a quest objective. Let's put something on the novice boots. Oh, they are holy boots right now. That'll burn my necromancer feet. But yeah, this is the basic thing of it. So now let's go and see the combat with the necromancer. These are all monsters, those are all chests. Use one stamina when you're moving. And yeah, the combat can sometimes seem a little, I don't know, maybe boring to some other people, but I enjoy it. Now, this is what the enemy will do. That means they will steal gold from me and attack me with 15 physical damage, but because I have armor, I'll resist some of that. And this is also their stats, so we are a necromancer right now. Meaning our melee damage doesn't do a lot of things. 10 damage or 16. And you also debuff him to take 7 damage each turn. And our little ghost friend also attacks and tanks for us, which is amazing. That poor ghost really loves us. Also a lot of random quests. You can get a ration. Experience. Well, I can't say no to gold. By the way, you should deposit your gold in the bank. Don't keep it with you because some events will cause you to lose a lot of gold. On the other hand, some events will need you to have some gold. And this is the dual strike. I mean, my special ability is of course dual strike because I rolled for it. Dual strike with double hit. That means I'll hit him 2 times with my weapon and also with my spell. So that should be a lot of damage. That was 55 damage. Of course my ghost will help me. And this is a critical attack and the dual strike again. Just because of the daggers I'm using. So yeah, sometimes you'll win a fight very, very fast. The warrior will take you a long time before you actually have enough damage to kill them faster. Oh, that was a lot of talking. Let's enjoy the game a bit more. And that's a chest. You have a 60% chance of being stoned by 28 damage. Let's open it. Again, you can loot everything and then just keep it and sell it later. Or use it maybe. Well, you have to choose one. Let's go over here. I guess I can use a chest key. Yeah, let's get some experience because you need to donate something to the altar. Yeah, I like the artwork in this game. Look at this big monster. If you have armor, you can escape, but it will get damaged. Stamina or damage? No, I don't want to take that much damage. Let's just run away and then use a mug of beer. Ah, that was refreshing. Experience? Heal. You are sleeping and you are thinking of useful techniques. This is your experience, stamina and health. As you can see, the game does a very good job of telling you what everything is and what you need to do. And we need to go to the second floor where we can start hunting some little minions here. And by the way, that's a boss, we'll fight him. Yeah, I just like to take a lot of items. And this is where things get interesting because this is a wagon that has a lot of items to sell. Shadow wooden staff. Well, as you can see, this has more damage, but my shadow dagger is still better. Also increases the water resistance, so you can have a lot of interesting equipment. So yeah, the dagger is more like built for dual strike. But you can also critical hit or double hit. But the physical power is very low because if you're not playing a knight or a paladin... Hey, music, I'm trying to think over here. You won't do too much physical damage, so let's go and fight the boss. Let's heal up my minion. And the bosses are actually very strong, but remember, this is the first floor only. As you can see, he has the same amount of health as me. And you get more health when you level up, based on your class. And he's not resistant to shadow damage. Wait a minute, he's resistant to shadow damage, more or less. Oh. Then I don't understand this. Okay, you definitely want to use the shadow power when you are attacking him. Just because of this effect. Now this will hit for 8. This will be for 6 and 1 because of the decay. Let's just hit him with our little knife. And this is a dual attack, so this is what we want to get more. And we can't charm him because he's not an undead, so yeah. That was the last turn. Come on, die already. It's just better to stack the shadow damage on him. Oh, he can resist my magic damage. And he killed our little ghost, the monster. Yeah, and he buffs himself. Oh, that's a lot of... So he basically can't attack him with magic anymore. But he still gets the damage from that, those effects. Holy Iron Boots. That was a very tough fight, and he killed our little ghost. But we got this side. This is a higher tier of items than us, because it's also uncommon, and they're very good. Sadly, it's only for the Knight of level 7 and the Paladin of level 7. Not really what I expected, but hey. I mean, our objective is on the second floor, so this is a small blue slime. It's not undead, I just like to check that sometimes, so we just have to kill it. But as you can see, this one is much, much weaker than the other boss. So just damage it with shadow magic. And each class plays so different that sometimes you don't even know how to play, for example, the Ranger if all you play is the Necromancer or the Knight or the Paladin. Yeah, let's do some more combat, because I like more loot. The second floor will be a lot harder, besides, We're just trying to get a new minion, and of course... more gold. It will deal a lot of damage to you, and these are the effects. My physical damage is reduced, and I'm also bleeding. Ah, don't worry, he'll die soon. Besides, when you level up, you get all your stats. And yeah, this is why sometimes you should use crystals to see where you are going. Khajiit has wares. Ah, we can rest right now. But we need more rations. Still not, but this, I think this is a quest minion. Still not an undead minion, but sometimes you can even find skeletons. And just look at that grizzly statue. Yeah, the Necromancer is definitely a lot stronger when dealing with the weaker monsters, because with the Knight I have a lot of problems. He tends to kill them slowly. If I had a scroll of charm animal, I would be able to tame the wolf, but since I don't, I just have to kill him. By the way, notice that he's very, very vulnerable to the shadow damage. Maybe because he's white, or I don't know. 3 decay damage. Oh, this will be such a hard hit. So yeah, definitely some minions, some enemies are a lot weaker to certain damage types. So that's why some fights you should skip, some fights you should take. I don't know, it's all up to you. Free quest, I prefer quests. Let's see what other minion this is. Oh, only slimes. Where are all the ghosts? Where are all the skeletons? Where are all my friends? I need a friend. And after I find a ghost or an undead minion, I'll just play a bit with the Paladin to show you how much different he is. Oh, come on, where are all the undead enemies? Is this a convention for the ants? Okay, now I'm starting... Now that I've explained the game and the basic stuff, I can relax a bit more, so yeah. Time to destroy the ancient ants. Because why not? We are evil, we are a necromancer. That's what we do. We bring death and destruction. And search for loot, of course. And maybe some corpses to experiment on. Oh, so now you can ask for two small. But wait, by the way, if you have maximum health potions, that won't work, so... Yeah, let's take that one, even though it costed us a lot of gold. It cost us a lot of gold. Perfect, this is exactly what I wanted, the skeleton. This means he has good physical protection and good physical damage. Come with me if you want to live. Yeah, so let's defeat him. Sadly, oh, he's actually very vulnerable to shadow damage, I wonder why. I guess it's the thing that made him, so he's vulnerable to what made him. And now he's our friend, as you can see. 98 HP, undead, resistant, plain, weak. Oh man, Infused Rust. So now we have our skeleton little friend. Yeah, let's gain a random item. Anyway, there are a lot of things you can use in the dungeon, so let me show you another thing, like the... Well, I could have used that scroll on the white wolf. Eh, whatever, we have a skeleton. Skeletons are better than wolves, right? You can also have some teleport scrolls and some other things. Now, let me show you how strong we become with the skeleton. That's so much fun, right? Yeah, and the necromancer tends to, you know, become very, very strong very early. Where the knight and the paladin actually need a lot of work. Yeah, let's go back, go up. I mean, look at my stats. By the way, if you sleep in the inn, that will actually reset the dungeon, so don't do that. Just get new items. Rations, beer, minion food. And then just sell your items. Don't need that. 400. Let's buy a random item for 400. That's a waste. And that's another waste, just because, you know, most of the times you'll get items that you can't use, but that's a very good bow. What happens? Yeah, it's almost like gambling, but except it's like a loot box in game. Let's go to the zoo. And besides, you can change your pets, so you can have up to 40 pets. So even if you don't want to use the weaker ones like the skeletons, you can just store them and use them later. Which I find amazing. Now, let's save this game. And let's start a new game. And this time, let's keep on playing on the normal difficulty. On hard, it's even harder, so it's quite a challenge if you like the challenge. Let's pick the paladin. I mean, the game is pretty easy to learn, but, you know, it's hard to master. That's the main quest. Get the random quest. I'll take a bit of a look at the item shop. Now, this is different because you have a lot of physical resistance and you deal a lot of damage. 24. Let's also see stats. As you can see, he doesn't really have a dual cast, a dual strike, or any of those abilities. So his main ability to deal damage is basically hit the thing with your hammer. So let's go into the dungeon. Yeah, let's fight our first monster. And he has a healing spell. So no more of that other stuff. And he deals 10 damage to us, just because he's pretty strong for the beginning. But once you get more equipment and more armor, it'll become very easy to kill. Double hit. 18 damage, nah, that's not so bad. That was not so bad, but again, it was a bit slower than the other things. Oh yeah, you also have this thing right here, which shows how many things you killed. These are his stats. 10% to duo critical or double hit, that's very low, so you want to, maybe you want to increase those. Yeah, I want a random piece of equipment. That doesn't work, okay, then give me a quest. Right now I want to get as many items as I can, just to have... okay, I'll take those just to sell them. Just to have more resistances and maybe a better item. Or a better weapon or something. That's for the berserkers, I think. More random encounters. Small regen potion. What is that? That's also very good because you don't... You get the health in different turns. Only knights can use the shield, so that's why it's not showing as an equipable item. Because this, I think this is a two-handed weapon. See? Now let's fight some more, because the beginning is very rough for the warriors that use melee weapons, as you can see. And it's a bit boring, yeah, I know. You don't have a minion, you don't have spells. And if you find something with a lot of armor, you will be in trouble. But I think that Necromancer was on the easy difficulty, so that could be also a factor. Let's use the rest. Okay, that's the main quest. I don't have any key, so I'm relying on my trap skill. No, let's run away from that thing. Five fire damage, five holy damage. That's unbelievable. So let me see. If you cast them right here, you'll actually get the resistance to them. So yeah, 10 damage is not exactly what you want. So that's why you'll be mostly using your melee weapons. At least on most monsters. Just so you can get those special attacks. Critical hit, that's pretty good. By the way, let's use your regeneration. Each time you level up, it becomes stronger. Hit him with your hammer. Oh! Because I'm dealing with acid, that didn't work, okay. Well, this is interesting. If you want to stall a fight, you can do it like this then. Yeah, so you can basically increase your regeneration very, very much. This is kind of a boring way to do it, and sometimes it will backfire on you, but hey. As you can see, we lost that critical attack just because we used the spell instead of attacking. So basically the paladin is very, very hard to kill if he has the regeneration buffs on him. Which is interesting, right? Look at this guy. Well, I don't want to lose the town portal skull, so I'll just fight him for that. 32 damage. Yeah, let's use a lot of regeneration because the paladin seems to be almost immune to certain effects. But as you can see, if we get a damage over time effect, it will actually cancel some of the regeneration. Well, I think this is more like a bug than anything else, but I think on the boss monsters it won't work. Hey, this is probably an intended effect, just to make it easier for the paladin, but this only makes the fights last a lot longer. Hey, but you do come out of them full HP, so that's a plus, I guess. Now, let's see what's in the last chest. Well, nothing I can use. Anyway, if you like the game, be sure to check it out on Steam, it's a lot of fun, and besides, not all the games need to be very hard or very punishing, they just not need to be a simple game that will help you relax or challenge you a little bit. Especially when managing your potions, your buffs, your pets and all that stuff. Anyway, see you next time, bye!